A few years ago, we were messing around as a family at our local high school football field. Upton clapped to cheer on the kids in whatever games they were playing or races they were racing. But I noticed something strange. The claps made a different sound depending on where I stood on the field. When I clapped at one spot, it made a weird echo. But if I walked a few steps down the field, I wouldn't hear that same echo. It didn't take me long to figure out that the echoes were caused by the stadium seats, with large ones on both sides of the field. But the echo was not like a usual echo. The echo came back in a strange sound. We kept clapping to see if we could figure out what it was about the stadium steps that made the strange echo. And we finally realized what was happening. The levels of the stadium seats were reflecting the sound at different distances, so we were actually hearing multiple echoes spaced closely apart. That satisfied my curiosity until I realized that I should be able to measure the distance between the stadium seats by using my phone and the pitch of the echo. Challenge accepted. Before we dive into this challenge, it might be interesting for you to know that this strange echoing from claps is perhaps most famous at the Mayan temple Kukulcan, or El Castillo in Chichen Itza, Mexico. When you clap in front of this structure, the pitch of the echo is very high there because the steps are so close together, which gives the echoes very little time between each other. Many archaeologists believe that this was an intentional design, done so that the echo of the clapping would mimic the sound of the sacred Quetzal bird, who to the Mayans was a messenger for the gods. So why do the close steps create such a high-pitched echo? Well, pitch is related to the frequency of a sound wave, and the frequency of a sound wave is determined by the time between the peaks of the sound waves. A long time between peaks means a low-pitched sound, and a short time between peaks means a high-pitched sound. The pitch of a sound is actually measured in the number of peaks per second. Middle C on the piano has a frequency of 261.63 peaks per second, while high C has a frequency of four times that, of about 1,046.5 peaks per second. The peaks per second has a name, it's called hertz, so middle C is 261.63 hertz. Now if we go back to the temple, the echoes are coming off without much distance between them, and thus time between them. The peaks of the sound are close together, so the pitch is higher. So how could I find the distance between the seats at the stadium while I was standing in the middle of the field? Well, since the distance between the seats changes the pitch, then the pitch I'm hearing must have the information about the distance between the seats. I only need to know two things, the speed of sound and the pitch. From an old Boy Scout trick, I know the speed of sound is about 1/5 of a mile every second. We use this to determine how far away lightning is when you hear thunder. You count the number of seconds between seeing the lightning and hearing the thunder, and divide that number of seconds by 5 to get the distance in miles. And since a kilometer is about 3/5 of a mile, the speed of sound is also about 1/3 of a kilometer every second. I could use those approximations as the speed of sound. I also had my smartphone though, so I could have easily looked up a more accurate value for the speed of sound as well. But there isn't much difference between my estimate of 333.3 meters per second and the more accurate estimate I found online of 331 meters per second. To get the pitch, I used an app on my phone called Physics Toolbox. It's a really cool app that allows you to gather data from all the sensors on your phone. You have a mic, a light sensor, multiple accelerometers, a magnometer, GPS connections, and others. I had it on my phone because I've used it to gather data for my students to use in math class. One of the options in the app is a tone detector, which tells you the tone or pitch in hertz. I tried to use it to detect the tone of the echo, but the echo was too short for it to detect the tone. So I had to use another tool, the tone generator, where you can put in the frequency in hertz, or beats per second, and it will generate a tone with that frequency. So while I was in the middle of the field, I generated the pitch that seemed to be closest to the one that I heard in the echo of my claps. The pitch that matched most closely was about 255 hertz, or 255 peaks per second. Or in other words, it took 1/255 of a second for the sound to travel from the front of one seat to the next seat level and back to the front seat level. And since I know the speed of sound, that many seconds translates to 1 divided by 255 times 331.5 meters, or 130 centimeters. That distance of 130 centimeters is the distance between sound peaks, but that's not the same as the distance between the seats. It is twice the distance between the seats. When the initial sound wave starts hitting the seats, one echo comes off and is traveling back while the initial wave is moving forward to the next seat, So by the time the next echo is formed, the previous echo is actually 2 seat lengths away. So the distance between the seats is half of the distance between the peaks, so about 65 centimeters. Well, I didn't want to go home and get a measuring tape and go back to see how close I was, so I just used my arm to measure from the front of one bench to another and put a mark on my arm with my handy dandy pen. I went home and measured the distance to the mark and found my estimation was about a half of a centimeter longer than the measurement on my arm. That is a pretty darn close estimate for being so far away and trusting on my ability to match pitches with my untrained ear. Well, that was fun. But who cares? There are easier ways to find the distances between the stadium seats. I could have just marked my arm in the first place and not had a hassle with the sound at all. But that is not a luxury available in every situation. Measuring distances deep in the ocean or in outer space, for example. Sound can be used to map the ocean floor using the same basic idea we use here. Now there are even LiDAR devices that measure distances and changes in distances using light, not sound. Instead of using waves to measure distances, you can modify what we did to measure speed, sending out bursts of waves and seeing how far apart they are spread when they reflect off of something is how radar guns work to find the speed of cars. So now for your homework, what is the width of the small steps on the Temple of Chichen Itza? You can use this video linked in the description and let me know what you get. If you can figure out other ways to find the width of the steps, put those in the comments as well. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.